So, okay, I did some changes to the UI, mostly because I didn't want to bother with the backgrounds for different resolutions. Okay, just a black box with a green outline, filtrator enough, it will do. Okay, so with this part, we're going to take things to the next level. Well, actually, we're going to take a level editor to the next level. But before we do that, let's fix a few stuff here and there. So I made a loading screen, or call it whatever you want, a loading window. And I've also made a window template, which if I want to make another window, we're going to take this from here and we're going to use this this window template over here. Now, let's go and see how they change. Although, as you will see that my menus are mostly the same, I reorganized them a bit. Obviously, you know, you can make your own over here. And I actually want to create one more button, which let's call. I want to bring this up and I'm going to say load texture. And let's call that load texture. Let's make it a little bit small. Oops, that's not smaller. That's more. Come on. Yeah, numpad doesn't want to work. Okay, load texture. So, the idea for this right now is even if the level editor is quite good, okay, we can make a few stuff. Of course, we can paint, but you know, who wants to paint? Well, actually, a lot of people want to paint, but to make or to speed things up, we don't have to always paint, especially in a level editor with limited abilities. So let's make it so we can actually load an image right from the internet, of course. Okay. And we're just going to be copy-pasting the link and it will be loading it. Awesome. So, let's see where we're going to do that. We're going to create another window template as I have over here. I'm going to copy this. And let's go and change a few stuff. I'm going to name this load texture UI. It doesn't matter the place. Well, actually, it does matter. It needs to render on top of any other UI you have. Okay, and of course, it needs to render beneath the mouse. Otherwise, we'll be missing our mouse. Our load texture UI then. This will be the input field where we are going to be pasting our link. Of course, we don't need to be seeing the entire link. Let's just change the placeholder and say paste link here. And on the button, we're going to have load texture. Close that. And on the text above, let's just say paste a link to an image in the field below, preferably if it's a PNG. Okay, you can only load with WooWooWoo class. You can only load PNGs and JPEGs. Obviously, JPEGs don't have any alpha. So if you want to, well, you know, PNGs can also be PNGs that don't have any transparent pixels. In either case, we can load them, but you have to, of course, clear it with the level editor. So the load image, yeah, you could play right away if it has transparency and stuff like that, but you can also, you know, if you want to, you can edit it right in the editor. Okay, we have that. Let's close it and let's go to our UI manager, or to one of our managers anyway, and let's go and add the new stuff we're going to need. For example, we're going to add the loading field, and let's go and add now the load texture UI. Okay. And now let's go. I don't want to mess a lot of stuff with the UI manager, even though it's going to be about the level editor. I think it's going to make a little bit more sense if we just keep it on the game manager. So here's the thing. Let's close all of it. And when we are loading an image from the internet, of course, it has to download. You can also take an image from the internet and not even loading, but it's not what we want or require over here. Because actually on the UI manager we need one more thing. Because we only load it once, then turn it into the level we have. Basically change the pixels of our level texture. And then we don't care about it. You can do whatever you want with it. Okay, I'm going to put one more field over here, and I'm going to call this link field. Close all this, and let's create. Actually, let's do this after start. Public void. Let's say you press to load texture from www. And we're going to go into the game manager, and we're going to say public void load texture from www, but we're going to be passing the actual link we have. Then we're going to run a coroutine, because it doesn't run in a single frame. It actually has to download an entire picture. The amount of time this is going to get, of course, is going to depend by your connection, if you are downloading something else, the size of the image, and all that. Obviously, since you can load huge pictures from the internet, obviously that depends. That means a lot more download time or loading time. Let's call this actual. And we still need to pass the link. So over here, we're going to say to our UI manager, open the loading. Set active to true, open the loading scene. We have the link, which is, we can rename this to URL, to be honest. If you want to, you can put checks, if the URL is not correct and stuff like that. Then we're going to do yield return. Actually, we want to do a class www, new www, and we need to pass the URL, and we have it above. Then we're going to have to wait till the www class has returned. And when it does, you can actually say www texture is null and do something over here, but we're not going to worry about this right now. Actually, you can just say UI manager loading set active to false. And let's write it to do. And we can say to do add case where the image failed to download. So, and you know what? Let's do it like this. So, we have our image, then we take a texture instance and we just assign it on, we do www.texture. Okay, so our texture instance now is the www texture. The www.texture, it returns as a texture 2D. So This basically makes our life easier. We don't have to worry about anything else. And actually, before we, instead of doing the texture instance, we can just use the level texture. Let's say if we want to load the level. Yeah, this is going to mess a little bit the... Let's see what we do on init level editor. We have our texture instance, yeah, set pixels. Okay, we're going to bypass the create level. It would have been good if we just load this from the create level, but okay, let's bypass it. It doesn't matter. So we need to change our texture instance now. Our max, well, basically our entire level. Although it's not necessary, you can, you know, if you want to just add pixels and it loads on top of your level and top of your level. But yeah, that goes a little bit further away. But of course, yeah, there's always options, as in life. And I want to take this the way it is and just paste it down here. And why this is going to work? We create a rectangle on the sizes we have. We take directly from the texture instance, okay, and then we have a level renderer. We create the sprite, texture instance, rectangle, vector 2, 0, of course, the pivot, 100 points per pixel, and then of course we want this to be a full rectangle. So this will load our level, and we can just say UI manager set loading false. Of course, we need to start the coroutine over here, and we pass the link, and we should call this from the UI manager now. And we're going to do game manager, singleton, load texture from woo. And the link field we want is basically link field dot text. Okay, let's do one more thing though before we finish with this, and say if string dot is null or empty, link, then do nothing, just return. Or you can just do throw an invalid link message. Now we need one more thing, which is on the UI manager. Let's make public void open text load texture UI. Okay. And what that's going to do is just say load texture UI, set active, true. I guess we should also include a close, public void, close load texture UI, load texture UI, set active to false. Okay, I think we might just need we can just use the editor buttons. Let's do that then. Level editor, close LT UI, load texture UI, open LT UI, and yeah, okay, let's put this here and say also open load texture from www. Okay, let's add the new cases. Edit type, close LT UI, edit type, open LT UI, case, edit B type, load texture from www, and let's see, we need a break over here. We always need a break. And UI manager, close LaTeX UI, UI manager, open LaTeX UI, and then UI manager, singleton, load texture from www. And we have one break that we don't need. Awesome. Okay, I think we haven't forgot something. So this will probably play. Let's close the extra game managers. And let's pin the first one, let's pin the level editor and pin this. And also pin the UI manager. Okay, close that. And let's go fix a canvas. So let's go and say game manager. Let's see, where's the UI manager? The UI manager is down here. Let's add loading. Load texture UI. It's here. The link field is going to be the input field. And yeah, these two will work. Because we added a few more things over here, let's go and add on, I think on the UI manager, do we have close all? Oh, on start. Set active to true. Let's see. Let's say loading set active to false. Load texture UI set active to false. Okay. Now, let's go over here. Let's find our buttons. Load texture. I'm just going to change the button type to not load texture from woo-woo, open load texture UI. Then on the load texture UI itself, we are over here. And we need to add two new buttons. So I'm going to copy this and just bring it above here. And that's why I changed the UI. So I don't have to mess with different resolutions. Just going to put an X over here, and then let's rename this to close, and let's add editor button, add the function. Oops. Yeah, nice. Editor buttons press, and this will be close load texture UI. Then on the next button, load texture, editor button, editor buttons press, and then load texture from www. Awesome. So let's test this. If we haven't done anything wrong, we might be able to actually get. Okay, we have the editor, load texture, and we need to paste the link over here. Let's see, let me find a link. Okay, so I have a link. The nice thing about this, it's still a box editor, so you can copy paste without having to worry anything. And I'm going to paste an IMGUR link. Okay, and I'm going to click load texture. It loads, and you can see that we get our image. Yeah, the image is kind of, it's like this. So any anti-aliasing you see, it's because of this. But because we have made all the entire thing behind it, we can come over here, clear. Because see, there is a line of pixels. I think it could be from the anti-aliasing. I'm not entirely sure. But I can still paint over here. If I want to give him a mustache, I can. And if I want to write something over here, okay, we can. Obviously, this destroys the image as well. We actually changing the entire picture, so it's exactly like painting. And yeah, we have the initializing. So let's maybe say go, let's go and see how we can make this slightly better, or a texture at least. Texture instance, let's say texture instance dot filter mode. Filter mode, let's make it 2 point. Let's see if this is going to make this look cleaner. Editor, raw texture, I'm going to paste the link. Raw texture, it loads. And yeah, it made cleaner. Oops, yeah. I went and hit Control Z, so anyway. Loading, close it. Paint him something. Or paint the sun over here. For reasons unexplained. Yeah, that's one ugly sun. But you get the idea. You can also clear. No issues. And you can see that the white line goes away because there is no initializing. So, because we have created the entire backend, we can say git good, save, and here's our level. Let's go back. We are clear. Select git good, and voila, there's your level. Right from a picture. Of course, yeah, if you have your picture pretty straightforward, you know, and it has a background with its transparent background and all stuff like that, then the less amount you want to use. Okay. The reason why I'm using a link and not just an entirely loading from the drive is because I want to turn this into a WebGL, demo, so you can actually play it and right before you start the series. You probably already seen this. Okay, and yeah, and we can of course change the environment, because why not? I guess that was a bad idea. Yeah, it was probably a bad idea. And yeah, as I said, the reason why I'm doing it this way is because I want to make this into a WebGL. Otherwise, you can just load it from, you can load a picture as we've seen previously, right from your drive. You can have your players just copy paste a picture image right on your drive, and you can even load them and do all those nice stuff. Okay, so I hope you can see how cool this is, especially since this is all online. You can put any image you want over here and it will load it. The only issue that I'm not entirely happy about right now is that it's going to also change the size of your level. Of course, there is ways to work around this, but you know, you can set it up to have limits. You can do anything you want. Obviously, if you use a pretty huge texture or image, there's not only a lot of loading times to worry about, there's also performance to think. Although I think, yeah, because the way it is, it's pretty optimized. It's not really that we have any issues with performance, as you can see. And yeah, it's pretty good. So I believe you won't really have a lot of issues, even with a bigger texture. But, you know, better safe than sorry, you know what they say. So yeah, this is really cool. Hopefully you can see this for yourselves. Let's kill somebody. We kill him. Okay, awesome. Which is super, super cool. Okay, try it for yourself. This is super nice. This frees your hands with a lot of stuff. You don't have to worry about making levels and anything like that. This is really cool. Awesome. So let's fix a few more things. Let's first of all create the minimap. Okay, we have an image. It's underneath a panel, and basically this is what we're going to change. Let's go into our script. Let's go into the game manager and then say texture 2D minimap instance. Let's go to the create level first. We'll see the changes we need to do. We're creating all of this. So similarly, we're going to create a new texture 2D, max X, max Y, minimap instance, filter mode, dot point. Awesome. And let's also create public color. Let's put it above with the rest of our colors. And let's call this minimap color. You can of course use the same colors, the same colors you have in your level, but it might just make it a little bit too noisy. Okay, minimap colors. So wherever we're changing this, actually for the texture instance, you can just do, since we are getting this from the level texture, you can just do instantiate level texture. Okay, and it will do the same thing with this. The only problem with this is that it doesn't read any data. It's not going to change any data, because what we're doing over here, we are getting the pixels we have from the first the level texture basically, and we are changing. This happens the same like the instantiate, but we also save information into our node. Okay, so we can use instantiate over there, and since we are also here, we can just say minimap instance set pixel x y, and instead of c just pass minimap color. Actually, let's rename this to color. Awesome. Minimap color, and over here we have the level renderer sprite. I think we also have somewhere over here it should be. Let's add an image, public image minimap render. And let's go level editor, not level editor, game manager. We have the rectangle, we can use this the same since they are the same value. And if we go UI manager minimap render dot sprite, and since it's a sprite, we can just say sprite create texture, not texture, minimap instance rectangle vector 2.0. Actually, the pivot, we might have issues with this pivot, we'll see. Sprite mesh type, oops, we want this to be a full rectangle. Close that, and we need also minimap instance apply. And whenever we do any changes into our texture, we should also be doing minimap instance set pixel clear nodes. Let's just copy paste this, actually from this to this to this. Okay, and it will change this to this. Okay, but when we are adding something, Let's see. Build node, build list of nodes over here. Copy this. Oops. Paste it down here. Let's change the minimap instance to this. And we're going to create this a minimap color. Awesome. And add fill nodes. Now we use this. Handle fill nodes. Yeah. Texture instance. Take all of this. And say minimap instance dx. And here it should be minimap color. And yeah, okay. Copy this. Paste this down here as well. Df. Df. Same with down here. Awesome. So, and of course we need to also apply. I think we might need to check. Oh no, okay, we are clear with this. And on the update, when we're actually applying any texture instance we want, we should also have minimap instance apply. Cool, okay. And let's see, I think we need to also do this, to do the same on the init level editor. Yeah, we do. And let's copy that. Paste this here. And say minimap instance set pixel x, y, and c. And actually, no. Yeah, it's going to make an empty texture instance, then minimap apply. And this will now be UI manager, minimap renderer, sprite, okay. Minimap instance. Awesome. Okay, let's test this and see. It's going to show if we forgot something or if we have anything. I think we forgot to wire this. So we should run, maybe run a few more logic for this one. And let's take the minimap. This is the minimap render. It's just an image. And let's go to the game manager, UI manager. Minimap render, drag and drop this down here, save, and then let's try it. I'm going to start with the level to see that it's actually working, and you can see that it doesn't. So let's see why not. From what I can see, it's just all, it makes everything green, but we should have be seeing this. Let's see if we hit native size. No. Unless we're rendering something on top of this, which I don't believe is the case. We're not. Okay. This was on init, so that means we were on create level. Minimap instance. Oh, yeah. Yeah. We have a minimap color. So let's see what was wrong with this. And oh yeah, this is wrong. So this will be if n dot is empty, else actually we don't need to be like that. say over here color MC, and it will start as minimap color. If N is empty, then MC dot A will be 0, and over here just add MC, 2 MCs and 1 TJ. Hopefully you know where that it's from. Okay, save that. We probably need to do this a little bit more down. Let's see now. Okay, let's see the image. You can see the outline of the image. It's over here. But we're failing to show it on the texture, on the actual image for some reason. Oh, yeah, because the color is black. Damn it. So change this to white. It's going to be white, but anyway. Okay. Yeah, it's not the best. The problem we have is it's not native to the resolution, so you're going to have a little bit more scaling depending on your level and stuff like that. Let's see if we use a raw image. Do we have any? Let's hit play. You can change the, yeah, I guess you can just hit preserve aspect. Okay, let's do this after we have done that. And say UI manager, minimap render, preserve aspect to true. And hopefully that will somewhat work with this. We can actually add maps and stuff like that as well. Should be no problem. Masks, not maps. We already have maps. Okay, and here we see the outline of our level. And not only that, if for some reason it starts to change, and they go out of bounds, that's why they fly that way. Doesn't really matter. Notice over here, okay, any morphology changes into the level itself, it's going to reflect right on the minima. Okay, this is super cool, as you can see. Really, really nice. Let's see if it's going to change them, to save them. And yeah, it did. Let's see. And I think we have the fill object somewhere over here. Let's try the fill object as well. Yeah, let's close the canvas first. Fill object. Let's drag it over here. And on the game manager, yeah, I open the canvas. On the game manager, just go and click add fill. And you will see the awesome thing that happens with our minimap, we are keep filling it up. And it actually reflects on the changes we have onto our level, which is super, super nice and super cool, as you can see. Awesome. Let's see how we are on time. I think it's a good stopping point for our for this part, to end it over here. We're almost done with the series. There's just a few cases I want to add more, just a few stuff I want to add more. Okay, nothing major, just a few changes on the level editor. Actually, let's try the level editor as well, and if it works there, level 2. Okay, and let's start painting. And Yeah, the mini map it's probably not going to work on the level editor. Let's see the image. I think it just doesn't update on the level editor. Okay, so let's see why it doesn't update. Let's go to the level editor. Where we want to paint, handle mouse input, and texture instance set pixel. Minimap. We have the target color and where we are passing clear, okay. So we're going to say color MC target color, not target color, minimap color MC dot the alpha, minimap color, not minimap color, target color dot alpha. So if our target color is clear and we're actually emptying it, then the minimap color we're going to be assigning is also going to be empty, which means this will probably work fine. And this will be minimap instance set pixel x tough y and mc. Beautiful. Save it. No, we want the level editor. Awesome. The only thing, yeah, I don't really like about is the resolution we get on that. Let's maybe fill this entirely. And we're going to let the preserve aspect work it out. And you know what you can do? You can get an image, you can make this as a mask and say mask, show mask graphic, we don't want to show it, and drop the image below. So if it goes over this, over the minimap, then you just disable it. And we can create, you know, something that reflects our camera field of view. Hit play. Editor. Okay, awesome. Let's try it with the, see how it looks with here. Yeah, it's not the best solution, but it will have to do one last thing on the editor. Load texture. Load texture. Okay, you can see the minimap stays like that, and we don't want this. So let's create a clear list of pixels. Let's create a call. Actually, let's find the load texture from www. Okay, it's here, and say void void update force update. Update minimap, and for anything we have on our texture instance, let's copy paste a few stuff. We want all of this, paste this down here. Okay, make it like that. And we should do get pixel, set pixel, get pixel from the texture instance. Okay, then color MC minimap color MC dot A will be C dot A, and instead of texture instance, say minimap. instance set pixel MC. Okay, after that, I think just applying the minimap instance should work. Force update minimap, and let's drop this one over here. Save it. Hit play. Editor, load texture. Oops. Yeah, that's not how it works. Let's take the link. And you can see that we actually paint. I think we need to also update this one as well. Let's take all of that. Let's take the rectangle as well. Let's throw a debug log just in case. Editor, raw texture. Okay, awesome. And one final thing is we should have disabled everything we do when the texture UI is open, basically. We should say, or if the loading is open. Let's see, I think maybe the UI manager should be, we should be saying this. Say public bool is loading. Public bool is texture UI. Open load texture UI is texture UI. True. Is texture UI false? Awesome. And load texture from Woo is loading. True. Then on the game manager, on to our coroutine for loading from this, we can say UI manager is loading false. Take all this then and also drop it in here. Okay, so on the UI manager, press ability button. This is never going to happen in the editor, so we don't have to worry about this. Let's see, UI level button. And yeah, this only changes the target level name, so we don't have to worry for this. Okay, then let's go to the editor buttons. Well, if you're pressing this, if... Okay, let's save the UI manager. UI manager, UI. UI manager singleton. Okay, UI, if UI is loading, simply return. If UI is texture UI and B type is not equals edit button button type, load texture from woo or let's put an or over here or edit B type close. Okay, return. And I think I wrote this wrong. Okay, so it will only allow this to play. You can actually change this as well to UI. It's only going to play if you want to close the UI or if you are loading the texture. But if you are loading like this, then it's not going to let you play anything or hit anything, hopefully. Editor, load texture. Okay, I can't click any of this, as you can see. Well, I can paint, so we're going to fix that as well. And we have the issue over here with the load texture. Let's see why. Oh yeah, this is not going to be any of it. No. So yeah, this is an issue. So we can just say if UI is okay. Let's do this a little bit down. If UI is texture UI return. That's going to be a little bit dirty, but anyway, no need to worry. Okay, close this, open this, and the rest was going to play. Awesome. Minimize. That wasn't the most elegant code we wrote, but anyway, we live with it. Raw texture. Okay, close, and yeah, we've seen that it works. Editor, raw texture, paste over here. Nothing else happens until we close this. Awesome. Let's fix the painting as well, which is inside Game Manager. Handle mouse. Mouse input. If UI manager is loading, return. Yeah, we could just put an OR over there anyway. It's texture UI, return. Hit play. Editor, load texture. As you can see, I cannot paint anymore. Paste the link, cannot paint. And when we are back, we still can paint because we have opened the load texture UI, but now we can paint normally. Awesome. This is really cool. Hopefully you can see this. So, you know what to do. Let's end this over here. You know what to do. Like, subscribe. If you like to see more, don't forget to check out the site so where you can see all the videos more organized in categories and all that nice stuff like that. Okay, and of course, if you like what I'm doing, if you like to support me so I can keep continuing making all of this nice stuff and other projects as well, of course, variety is the spice of life after all. Okay, then please consider supporting me either on Patreon or via Gumroad by buying a project or two or three, you know, as many as you want. And of course, via Patreon you also get additional rewards, so check the rewards, check what you're interested in, and I'll see you next time.